Hello everybody and welcome to Need Mentor. In this particular session, we are going to talk about the counseling process starting to end, whatever all the documents required in order to take admission in NRI quota, and what will the fee structure and in what score you can expect to get a seat through NRI quota. Okay, so if you are new to the channel, you subscribe the channel and be with me in this video until end to know everything about the everything about NRI quota counseling process. Okay, in case you want to avail our paid services, you can avail and we will support you starting from analysis process, which all options is applicable to you and which all options are practically possible and how you can proceed in order to get those planning implemented so that ultimately we have a seat in your dream branch within your all the criteria like tuition fee and location and your dream branch. Okay, in case you are not able to get the seat this year due to any reason, maybe budget limitation or such things, then we can continue for the next year without paying any extra amount. And for the paid counseling guidance, there are two numbers given on the screen, 9319128677. You call on 9319128677 for paid counseling guidance, and on the other number 8076051875, you can call for your queries. In case you have like your call is going busy, then you save the number and send us WhatsApp messages so that I can reply the messages with your queries and any other thing promptly within hours or like 10 minutes 15 minutes bandwidth you need to give us. So let's get started. And in the description you have some ebooks, that are those ebooks you can purchase related to deemed universities, DNB, or open state counseling process. And in case of paid counseling guidance, we will provide all those ebooks for free. So let's first talk about NRI quota eligibility for NEET PG admission. So all the criteria that is required to be fulfilled for a normal seat, non-NRI seat, you must be fulfilling all those criteria. Apart from that, you need to have a separate list of criteria to be fulfilled to come under NRI quota. Okay, so applicant must be holding a valid passport, that's first criteria, and seat offered under NRI quota will be allocated to the NRI candidates. Suppose you registered NRI candidate. Just to register as NRI candidate, you don't require to be an NRI student, okay, or NRI person. You need to have a sponsor who should be committing to sponsor your study, and the payment will be done in the foreign currency. So there are set of documents. I will talk about those documents in detail. Okay, so first is valid passport, and you will be allotted only those seats which are under NRI quota. In case any state doesn't have any seat reserved for NRI category, you won't be allocated those seats. Candidate must have qualified NEET PG examination. Those candidates who are still waiting for cutoff revision and they are missing the cutoff score by a small margin, or like 25 marks or 30, 40 marks, they need to wait until the cutoff revision happens, and on the scorecard they have sufficient score to qualify. Candidates applying under NRI sponsorship must be having a real blood relation to the financial supporter. When I say financial supporter, is nothing but the person who is sponsoring your education, and the person should be NRI person, and they need to have set of documents. So under real blood relation, the sponsor can be mother, sister, father, brother, or aunt or uncle. Now let's take a look at the most important part, is the list of documents required. Okay, so list of document required. Okay, the first document is documents claiming that the sponsor or the financial supporter is an NRI, valid NRI person. So his passport, his or her passport and visa of the sponsor, the first document, passport and visa. Second is relationship of NRI with the candidate. The candidate who is applying for NRI seat registration, and the relationship between the financial supporter or sponsor. So that relationship is very much important. You can't name any person who is like in your family related somehow. Maybe the person is very close, but the person should be falling under particular relationship, should be in blood relationship, real blood relationship. As per the Honorable Supreme Court of India, they have given what relationship will work. And second important point is, in deemed universities, whichever relationship works, it might not be working for particular state registration process for NRI quota. So the states has got different rules, and deemed universities has got different rules for their NRI seat. Okay. Third document is the affidavit from the sponsor or the financial supporter or NRI person that he or she will sponsor the entire course fee of the candidate duly notarized by the notary. So these documents have a format. If you want the format, I can get you provided the format under the paid counseling guidance. Fourth document is a certificate from embassy of the sponsor, and that certificate from the consulate. The person, NRI person, is in US or some other like Canada. So from that state, Indian embassy in that state, in the country of USA, you need to get the certificate from embassy. So these are the four important documents. You must have these four documents valid. Otherwise, your application as NRI may get rejected. And which states have got NRI seats? So these are the states have got NRI seat apart from deemed universities. Like Karnataka, they have other quota and NRI quota. Maharashtra, Rajasthan, Madhya Pradesh, Andhra Pradesh, Telangana, Tamil Nadu and Kerala. Okay, so they have got different tuition fee for NRI seat, and there will be different cutoff. So you can't expect, you just have the qualifying score, you can get the NRI seat anywhere. It all depends on like tuition fee and what is the competition level and what is the documents required. Do we have sufficient documents or not? The fee structure starting from 40 lakhs or maybe less than that, 35 lakhs, 37 lakhs also in India for NRI seats, and it can go up to 1.65 lakh 5 crore per year. When you can register as NRI candidate, take an example of deemed university. The first round you applied as management category candidate, or take example of any state like Karnataka, and you have a second round or the mock-up round station open. In the further rounds, you are eligible to register freshly as NRI candidate. In case you realized that you don't have sufficient score to get seat under management quota through the counseling process, then you are eligible in the further rounds to register NRI candidates. You collect all the documents with proper relationship and a sponsor, and you can apply as NRI after first round also, or in the beginning of the round one also you can apply as NRI candidate. Expected cutoff score. In case you just got just qualifying a score, you still expect a seat to get in NRI, but it will have different terms and conditions depending on the state. They might also ask for bank guarantee in some of the states. So you must read the rules, and the tuition fee will be in higher side, might be very very high. So you need to do calculation accordingly. And if you're going for some colleges where the NRI tuition fee is less, and still you are expecting to get a seat in top clinical branches, you have to do the calculation rightly. What will be the cutoff? Because the cutoff score and the tuition fee both will be going. If the tuition fee is high, and then cutoff will go low. In the low rank also, you can get those colleges where the tuition fee is high. But you are looking for some NRI seats in low tuition fee, then you need to have better score in NRI quota as well. So with this information, I conclude my video. And if you have any question, you can message me on WhatsApp. For the queries, I request you to message me on WhatsApp. Please don't call. It takes more time, and I can quickly answer your queries over WhatsApp. You can have long chat as well. Okay. So thanks for watching again, and have a great day.